fear your compelling lecture must come to a close. Why can't they catch on?
Oh, for fuck's sakes.
God only knows.
Psst, sister. Sister, I've returned with a tale to report.
Father Gunderson, tell me about your tour. I can assume that you did something filled with distaste. I can see that guilty expression on your face. Corruption and evil, this church is infected. Think of the children our priests have molested.
Please. Please be quiet. I'll be brief. I will now tell you the truth. It brings me such grief. South America was a mission of trouble. Never did I think this godly quest would stumble. Our dear Father Toka found trouble in Peru. Yes, he found pleasure by taking it in the doo-doo. He found his new pastime hot, like sriracha. Entered more trouble at Lake Titicaca. Now Father Toka will never return to report. Poor man, he met a small boy that he deeply yearned for. Latinos don't take kindly to molestation the way that they heard him. Thank God for immigration. Those violent people, they were such wreckers. They tied him to a tree and cut off his pecker.
Go on.
We escaped with poor Father Toka on a gurney. So off on a plane, we headed to our next journey. So off to Canada, where we crossed one more disaster. Arrived in Quebec, we crossed those dirty French bastards. They made us bring forth each fervor and emotion. They explore sex like Columbus did the oceans. There, Father Toka faced his biggest fear. The poor, beaten-down eunuch admitted he is queer. He decided to stay, live the life delectable, by offering his ass as a meat receptacle.
That's wrong, but I still must cry. Now go get me my gun, those fuckers will die.
Oh, I'm sorry, sister. I'm sorry, but I cannot take part, for I met a Frenchie who fulfills my heart.
How dare you, Gunderson? This is insane. Now spit it out and tell me this boy's name.
Once again, sister, you are misunderstanding, for it is not a young boy that I'm romancing. Yes, it is a grown woman. I enter her womb. It may be wrong to the Lord, but...
You are doomed.
Oh, sister, there is nothing wrong with us lying in bed, for I gave her a ring. We are to be wed. Being an unwed priest is such a woeful chore. So I purchased myself a French-Canadian whore. Before you begin to fume, just let me explain. Yes, she is French and not...
I hope she's potty trained. Now, we have had some close calls, but this is quite the lie. Our church members were fume. Oh, this they will not buy.
Well, sister, you're smart. Can you think of something to say? I mean, come up with ideas? Turn their focus away?
We're an organized religion. We're perfect at that. Why take blame and find someone to point the finger at? After all these years, remember what we are taught. You are a Catholic priest. It's never your fault. Christians and Catholics, we're all the same. Just look around you. Find someone else to blame. Because it's your high position you want to keep, so you just keep your mouth shut. Never take the heat. Your sheep will believe you and never hold you liable. Just smile at their words and always hold your Bible.
An idea has come to me. Oh, yes, sister, there is hope. Let's pick on a family. They can be our scapegoat. If I lift up these cursed people, then I may confide. They will see me a hero, and I won't have to hide the fact that I picked up a mail-order bride. What about the Jones family? Oh, to God, they are blind. I'll force them to praise me for being the one that helped them find Lord Jesus, God's only son.
What better way to expose them as sinners? Why don't you see them for Thanksgiving dinner?
Oh, they are so dumb and naive.
I'm glad they won't conceive, for God they still believe.
And we will be free to deceive.
On your trip to Canada, you stepped on some cracks. Now it's time for us to clean up those dirty tracks. With leaders like us, religion is quite out of luck. For we're still human. We drink, curse, tell lies. And we fuck.
That you ask. I met Frank at church at early Sunday Mass. He sat all by himself in such sad despair, so I sat next to him and said, "Have no fear." With a hand on his shoulder, we looked up above, and then I looked into his eyes and fell so in love.
How wonderful, Walter. Doesn't this please us?
Shelley has brought me much closer to Jesus.
Walter, listen to what our baby speaks. God, I'm so a woman now. Jesus, Frank, I'm just so surprised I want to scream out loud.
I know. I'm so happy. Frank makes me so proud. I have now turned him into a Republican sage and force-fed his brain with fundamentalist rage. And I showed him the truth. He knows it so well. If he's not a Christian, he'll burn in hell. He asked for God's love, and now he shall have it.
What a bunch of horseshit. We raised him Catholic.
Oh, Mr. Jones, no need to feel so threatened. Catholics burn in hell, something I won't mention. Catholics do go to heaven. So I've heard. You may be different, but you follow his word. Now, there's one more thing that I must say before I...
Where's my brother Jimmy? Is he not here?
Jimmy is coming. He's bringing me beer.
Brother, where have you been? By the looks of this bitch, you've been slapping skids.
Oh, gee whiz, Jimmy, just watch what you say. Shelly's a good girl, she's not that way. But now that you're here, tell me what's new, any life-changing moments exceeding you?
Oh, come on, Jimmy, don't be shy. It's something to be proud of. He was stuck in the rut, and he just got himself out of. He was a little boy, but now he's a man. The only lover he ever had was his right hand. Now that Jimmy did something to make us all feel merry. Last week, he finally lost his cherry.
Oh, times like this that make a mom cry. What a wonderful memory for Jimmy.
The only problem is them hookers ain't cheap. It makes me send my wallet thinner.
What am I hearing? You are a sinner. Well, I can't believe what I just heard you say. You let a hooker take your innocence away? Was a few measly dollars an even trade?
He ain't got my good looks. How else are you going to get laid?
I must admit, and it makes me so sad, but Walter isn't Jimmy's biological dad. I know this must come as a big surprise.
I have two eyes. Jimmy is Persian, and that fact is very clear.
Well, one Christmas night, I was short on cab fare and all out of drugs with no money to spend. So this dear cab driver offered to be my new friend. His name was Muhammad Abu Adulabuk. Now all that cash, I was just so shit out of luck. Not sure what to do. I was confused and I was sick, so he offered I'd pay by thugging on.
Oh, shit!
And at this time, our marriage was quite stormy. Head for towheads. Oh, these fuckers are horny.
Honey, can we please switch gears? This I cannot take.
To finish my story, Jimmy is a mistake. And although he is a Jones, we raised him Persian. They often become rich engineers or surgeons. We taught him that Allah is his path to heaven, and his first job was a clerk at a 7-Eleven. We taught him, like all Muslims, that women are so weak. And we only let him shower maybe once a week. Ugh. Oh, here, Jimmy, your forehead, where'd you put your dog?
Enough with this story, Mom. I'm begging you, stop. Where's my sister Connie? Is she here yet? Off studying hard for finals, I bet. Yeah, last time I saw her, she was working hard in college. so overcome with beauty and so filled with knowledge. I bet she has a boyfriend that's smart, kind, and buff.
To the contrary, brother, she's out chasing the muff. No longer Vincent, she's been quite rebellious. Some of the girls she brings in makes me so jealous. New girlfriend is hot, sexy, and quite funky. Heard them making love, so started spanking the monkey. The way the dykes are moaning, the sex must be great.
Are you telling me Connie's no longer straight? Stop it, brother, with this story you are sharing. This is something that Shelley should not be hearing.
We're always proud of our children. What can I say?
No, no, we're not ashamed. We raised her that way. Now that Connie's a lesbian, we find it so thrilling.
And, well, I told the guys at the bar, and, well, they also find it appealing.
Your daughter is a lesbian? This must not be commended. The fact that you're proud of this, sorry, but I'm so offended. I'm a fundamentalist. We can't stand your tolerant ways. We hate all those that are sinners, mainly those gays. How can you be accepting that your daughter is queer?
Speaking of morons, Father Gunderson's here.
Father Gunderson, what a lucky guy. Did you see his French-Canadian horror mail order bride? How can they connect the French he only speaks? Why else would that beautiful girl marry that creep? Connie and her girl are with his wife, both taking turns.
And what were they doing?
Giving each other rug burn? That poor girl stuck with that old creepy man.
Oh, a priest with a mail order bride? He'll be damned to the violent, fiery, hellish pit.
Well, we birthed a feast on her.
Shit! What we're talking about Gunderson is, and his wife is not a concern how he lives his life.
Hello, Jones family. Finally, I have arrived. Now the Christ is in us, and in us he is so alive. This is my bride. And Lord, do I love her so. How about a kiss, my dear lovely wife?
No!
Before our love at first sight collision, manners were foreign to her poor vision. Some people might think that my faith has just died, the fact I'm a priest and found me a bride.
Oh, Father, we don't mind this burden that you carry. We know you're a priest. We're not going to judge that you're married. I'm glad you finally put to you your salami. So, have some dinner. Hey, Ava, where's that Connie?
Oh, dear. My wife has only been here a short while. Your heathen daughter introduced her to that lifestyle. Your daughter and her friend, I truly dislike. They are nothing but two blasphemous dykes.
Father and Mary, we are quite pleased. Connie, my love slave! Get down on your knees. Ravage me, darling. I'll keep my eyes shut.
Get away from my wife, you heathen slut.
Father, are you still mad at me? Just let it go. Your wife is a lesbian, and I know it is so.
You should all get on your knees. For a prayer. This family offends my dear Lord Savior, for lesbians are wrong in the eyes of the Lord.
Oh, if only you heard, like a lion she roared. We went right to the sex, no antics, no drama. She screamed like she was giving birth to a llama. Both Connie and I have made your wife our sex toy. You priests can't please women, only six-year-old boys. The things we did to her, I find it quite scary. I think that with just one finger, I popped her.
Mary! These things that you speak of are getting obscene. She gets what we did. Try not being so mean.
These distasteful things that you speak of are so rank. Thank Jesus I was able to save dear Frank. When wounded with sin, Jesus should be your crutch. You are all victims that my heart must now touch. Now, let me get my Bible. I won't waste any time.
Listen to this woman. I need to get myself some wine.
Yeah.
So she changed her ways after what Jesus had taught.
Ooh, this Mary Magdalene is made. It can be hard, don't go to the next page. But please tell me more, for she met Jesus. Let's talk.
My heart is filled with pain.
Well, who needs a yin when you can have two yangs?
Oh, I agree. How can we be so satanic? Two girls locking lips, ooh, it's so romantic. Last night I heard these girls, their bedpost, it was bumping. I got so excited, my heart was thumping. I know Connie's my sister, but for goodness sakes, two girls going at it, ooh, my member can't take.
Enough of this sex talk, you were all missing my point.
All right, change the subject.
Statement is invalid.
I know for a fact that man tossed a salad.
Looks like we have a great wager to make.
Well, what can you bet? Anything at stake? Just give me a deadline, yes, you name the date. The man's a queer, that's why he sees us with his. He looks at his gaze with such great alarm, but never did we try to put him in harm. I just do not get it. This man holds such grudges. If our lifestyle is wrong, then let your God judge us. Maybe he's sinners, but he should keep his mouth shut. I know for a fact that he takes it in.
What? If this is the truth, it brings me such sadness. Gay servant of the Lord? What great madness! I won't believe it, with all my faith on the line. I know he's not perfect, but God's light, it still shines. He would never allow a member of a congregation to take part in such a terrible degradation. I know his word well. And with great precision. And if I'm wrong, I'll denounce my religion.
Woo! This bed is insane, and don't you dare try it.
Frank, mind your own business. You just be quiet.
Shelley, your best, why it shocks me. Such a large, tender. And if I lose this bet, then my lust I'll surrender. Now I will hurry at it. I can't wait to expose. Jimmy, will you help me out here? May I try on your clothes? I cannot wait to show that this Gunderson is gay.
Well, get on it, you sinner. I'm giving you one day.
Mr. and Mrs. Jones, now, I have a confession. Healing those from sin, well, it is my profession. Now, I have an offer that I'm sure you shall take, if only you'd admit that your ways are a mistake. I ask that you come and attend my sermon. Admit that you're battling Satan, that vermin. Ask for forgiveness and praise me with a rave. Confess that without me, your souls would not be saved. The great Father Gunderson.
How dare you even try and make us admit that we're such sinners? You're so full of shit. I'm not gonna stand for these terrible lies.
Just ask for forgiveness before your flesh dies.
I think you should leave.
Same here.
Wait, let me finish. I'm trying to help you make your sin diminish.
You're the last person to judge us, you phony. We don't need you.
Just
help.
Hear me out.
Oh, blow me. I won't listen to this bullshit any longer. For you to judge my family? You couldn't be wronger. You sly little runt. You should question yourself. Have you forgotten about your whore for a spouse? Look at you acting like a sing-stepping guy.
Well, I am.
You're nothing but a fraud. Did you think about God when you purchased this trip? He sent her in the mail package with a stamp. How can you sit there and pretend to express grace? A woman has to wake up to your dreadful face. She must vomit at your sight.
How dare you? Oh, you want me to fight back? But I don't care to. You're just looking to offend me. Lord, what's next? What else is so bad about us?
I know.
Just sex.
Oh. I may be Canadian, but I still have desires. And all this man say, well, I know he's just a big liar. When it comes to sex, I am very addicted. The way he makes love is just so
insipid. I'm sorry, you're cursed. Oh, what a dread. Poor little thing you're bound to has been. But let's get to this problem. Why sit here and linger? There are other ways than just using your fingers. So come to my room and I'll show you to a nerve.
Honey, wait for me, I will do it, sir!
Why won't they bow down to me and acquiesce? Sister Salacious has put me at such a great test.
Hi there, sir. By the way, my name is Harry.
I know you.
You must have met my sister, Mary?
Oh.
Yes.
I know, we look alike. What else can I say? We have so much in common. Both of us are gay. Oh, looking at you, a sight I've never seen. What I want to do to you, you may think obscene. I'm good at sex. Some men say I'm a professional. How about we do it in church? In a confessional?
What are you saying? I cannot believe.
They say you like guys.
Well, you have been deceived.
There is no other man who I'd like to hold tight. Look inside your poor desires, please. Don't you find it's just the way you walk and the way you talk? I know that you yearn for the taste of...
I'm shocked.
Do not turn away and pretend this is insulting. The touch of a woman, you find it revolting. I saw you some time ago preaching to your sheep, and all I did was dream of you behind me so deep. My lust is not shared, and I will scream it out loud. Would I change your mind if I was well endowed? So here I offer this for your carnal pleasure. From man to man, below I give you my treasure.
What are you doing, feeling up between my thighs?
I felt some elevation. This proves you tell lies. You've defended yourself well, but you cannot be pardoned, for the proof is the fact that I forced you so hard in.
Well, your accusations are so very incorrect.
Well, say, Father, then why are you so erect? Father, accept it. You can never hide it. Just admit it. This man makes you excited.
Six boys. Six boys. Eight boys.
Okay. This is a secret I've been carrying.
Father, that look in your eye is scaring me.
All right, Harry. You've exorcised my demon. Feeling so hot. My sweat, it is steaming. So let's get naughty.
Oh, Father, what's with this shit?
Well, the way that you touch me, it made me so stiff.
Father, you turn so perverse, you scare me.
But it looks like the tables have been reversed. Yes, I've lived a lie, but I can no longer hide it. For so many dreadful years, I tried to fight it. But there's something about you, boy. I'm so awakened. My emotions are heating. My nerves are shaking. You caught me, sir. I am such a liar.
You remove your hand, sir. I must retire.
Lust
has made you much ruder.
So church is gonna be
everything. Get away from me! You intruder! I told him 100 times I'm not that kind. He's corrupted by Satan, possessed of the mind. I said get away. I even said please.
Bullshit, Father! You were practically on your knees! Father, you were after me and so sensually. They cannot see this. They will eventually.
By the looks of the Father, he's been abused.
He admitted the truth!
This queer is confused.
Enough with this conquest. I must depart.
That poor boy. Oh, Jesus. Please bless his heart.